Hey, in this video, I'm going to introduce you to a new feature inside Helium 10 Magnet and Cerebro. I'm going to show you what this feature is all about, how it works, and how you benefit from using it as an Amazon seller. Also going to tell you that it's really good for your Amazon product research, also good for your keyword research, and for your inventory management, which are pretty crucial steps for your Amazon success. I'll do my best in this video to explain you how you can leverage this tool for your better success on Amazon. So if this is something that talks to you, please watch the video fully. Now, my name is Vova. I'm an active seller on Amazon. Been selling there since late 2016. Been using Helium 10 as a tool since 17, I think. I can't remember quite right, but been a while and still using it. So I have some experience that I wanna share with you. Now, look, if you don't have Helium 10 account yet, Helium 10 is a suite of tools for Amazon FBA. It's kind of all-in-one set of tools for product research, keyword research, listing optimization, automated emails and whatnot. I recommend you checking out Helium 10. You can create a free account. Down the description is going to be a link for you to create your free account. It's going to be an affiliate link, and I do recommend you checking it out. Once you have your account, yes, you can sign up for free here. Click on login and let's get inside and see the tutorial. So in the keyword research part, we have the Magnet and Cerebro tools. Both of them will help you find better keywords for your product. And what's Magnet's gonna do? For example, if we type in here kitchen knife, this is something I usually use for my tutorials, it will spit out all the connected keywords to kitchen knife. And in the Cerebro part that we're gonna go through a bit later on, we can use the competitor's ASINs. ASIN is a specific number on Amazon that you input inside the Cerebro tool here inside Helium 10, and you will see exactly where your competitors are ranking at. Therefore, you can take their keywords and use them in your own listings. So once we've typed kitchen knife here, we've got a bunch of stuff here on the screen, and you're like, wait a minute, Vova, I don't understand what's going on. Well, if you've never used these tools, there's this thing called Learn here, where you can click on the Learn, and it's gonna give you some tutorials by Helium 10 itself that I really recommend you trying as well and checking out as well. And there's also a free course here on this YouTube channel, on my YouTube channel, that's called Helium 10 Listing Optimization Course. In this course, it's a 3-hour course, free course, no upsells, really tons of good stuff there based on my experience. I show you how to create a really good listing on Amazon. So it's gonna be down in the description for you as a playlist. And in case you wanna see how to use Magnet and some other features of Magnet, use it. But our special feature that we wanna talk about today is here. It's called Search Volume History. I'm gonna explain you what it's all about. So let's click here on all time and let me explain you this graph. Now, this is the search volume for a given keyword based on a period of time. That means how many people were searching for this keyword in a specific period of time, okay? And why is it good for us? Why is it so revolutionary? Well, based on this, you can understand when there were more sales for this product as well, because it was having more searches. For example, that's a kitchen knife, right? And we can see the spike here. Look at this. When does the spike happen? From November, summer 16th, November 23rd, November 30th, December 7th. You understand what's going on here? Yes, that's a Christmas giftable product. Throughout this edition, we can understand that the search volume was bigger during this time. That means more people were searching for this, and that means that there were more sales. And on this, you can base your product research. For example, once you're searching for products, you can use this little tool and see, where does this product sell? When people are searching more for this product, or maybe when they're searching less. For example, if it's a seasonal product, if it's a summer product that's sold during the summer, during the winter, usually you'll see a dip inside the search volume history. That means people are searching less for this. And you can see exactly when it starts dipping. So you can base your inventory kind of predictions on these things, because then you understand, well, if for a seasonal summer product, the sales start dropping somewhere in mid of September, then you understand that, yes, after this, I'll be selling less. That means that I will need less inventory, and that means I'll need more inventory when it starts catching up. That means maybe somewhere in March, yes, when the summer period is coming, the search volume of this keyword will go up, yes? And this, on this, you can base your assumptions on when it's gonna sell more. In my opinion, it's really awesome because you can really base your product research better on this, because you'll see actually when they're searching for it, when there's more search, when people are buying, when there is demand for this product. That's very important. And your inventory management will also be based on this. Well, not only based on this, there are many things connected to inventory management, but one of them, essentially understanding when people are searching for a specific product and when they're not. And you can have this for all the time, which starts in the early January 2019. So we have data almost 2 years back, which is pretty cool in my opinion, because you have all the 19th year to kind of go through, as you can see from the 5th of January 2019 to 5th of January, to 4th of January, say 2020. A whole year of data, and you can check it for different products. Yes, that's specifically for essentially for different keywords. I'm sorry, not different products, yes? And here is 1 year of search volume history, and you can understand, so what are these spikes here? July 20, 2019, maybe that was Prime Day, I can't remember right, that might be Prime Day. Yes, because it's like very huge there, or something else happened in July, I don't remember exactly, but you can base your understanding on these things, on this data. This is coming from Helium 10 that bases it with their algorithms on Amazon. That's not exact, accurate numbers, however, they're kind of close to reality because they have their own ways to validate them. So I do encourage using this thing. And also in the Cerebro part, yes, Cerebro is where we, as I mentioned before, take a product of a competitor. Say I take this product, we take their ASIN, and ASIN is a special number on Amazon that you can take from any product. It's kind of easy to do that. It's in the search bar on Amazon. You will have a specific product. For example, for this specific product, that's a kitchen knife as well. This was the number. So then you click on get keywords and you will get the keywords that are connected to this product. And pretty much the same idea here as in the magnet, because it's also gonna spit a bunch of keywords where this specific product is ranking. And we can take a specific keyword, and again, we can execute the search volume history in order to understand if the keyword is doing well or not, or what's going on. And here it's loading. It took a bit more than I thought. You know, it's also really hot here a bit because I turned off the AC. And I closed the windows to isolate the noise of the cars and stuff like that, but it doesn't really matter because here we have the keywords. And as you can see, for example, we have Japanese knife that's connected to this product. Let's click on this one and we have the search volume history again here. That's for Japanese knife. Essentially, again, you can do this also through magnet if you type in Japanese knife there, but through Cerebro, I was just able to pull it out the relevant keywords to this product. So as you can see here, for Japanese knife, the history is pretty much the same, well, kind of the same. July 20th, again, was a spike. I think it was Prime Day, I can't remember right, or something else. But for Japanese knife, again, the kind of the idea is similar. So we have November, it's catching up, it's peaking in December 21st. That's the last people that order their presents while they're still shipping for Christmas to make it on time. And then it falls down and continues to August 20, which is right now. And you can, again, search for seasonal products this way. You can understand, for example, you're trying to launch a Halloween product. You're like, let's see when it actually starts catching up, the search history. And then if you launch the product beforehand a little bit, you will kind of ride the wave, all right? And in this way, you can really understand it based on this little simple addition. I would really recommend you try and use it. Again, you have the Helium 10 free account down in the description to create and try it out, along with some discounts if you ever want to invest. If you have any questions, ask or add your thoughts about this. What else can you add? Maybe something that I haven't added or something you would like to ask me. I would be glad to answer. And now up here, you're gonna find two other videos. One is the overview of Helium 10 set of tools by Bradley Sutton, where Bradley kind of went through all the tools. Bradley's from Helium 10 itself. Maybe you're aware who this guy is or not. It's a great interview in my opinion, got a really good response. And here is the list of Helium 10 tutorials. All my tutorials are here that are connected to Helium 10. Have a great day. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video.